In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to download and install Audacity and then use it to sound better in your content. Maybe you are shooting YouTube videos or you are just trying to create an audio that can sound very, very interesting and fantastic. So Audacity is a free available software. It's a free open source cross-platform audio software that you can use to create any of your audio. You can share and reshare the content. You're free to record any kind of audio with it. Audacity is an easy to use multi-track audio editor and recorder for Windows, Mac OS and Linux operating systems. Okay, so you can have it for Windows, Mac OS and Linux operating system. So once you're on the Audacity website, it quickly detects your device and then it provides the download for your device. Right now I'm using Mac operating system, so I can easily click on download and it will download the Mac operating system version. So to get to Audacity's website, you can just come to your browser and just come to the search bar here and just type audacityteam.org. And once you type this, it's going to bring you over here. So to download and install, it's very easy. It's an easy to download, easy to install software by just downloading. It's a click through software to install. So just go ahead and click to download and install it on your PC as well. So once you're done downloading, you can just come all the way to your gallery and just search for Audacity. And you can see it over here, Audacity. So you just click to open and it's just going to open this very dialogue. Okay, so this is Audacity platform. So to begin with, let me show you the very basic things you will require as you work with Audacity. To your top left over here is the key basic recording and playing options. For example, you can click on the red button over here, which is the record button, if you want to record your audio. And if you want to skip to start or skip to the end, you can use these two icons over here, and then you can stop with this icon. You can move two frames, you can move forward and backward, and you can pause also from here. Okay, so these are other features. For example, you may want to select later on. Maybe I'll show you how to use some of these features. Audacity has recently been upgraded in that all the audio setup are now incorporated in one item or in one tab over here. Okay, so once you click on this audio setup, you can see a bunch of different things. For example, the host, core audio, and you can see playback device. This is where you can select which device you want to record on or you want to play back on. Okay, so when you want to play the audio, which of the devices do you want? So there are various devices over here. I prefer to use my MacBook Pro, but if you have some headphones, you can easily use them as well. Recording device also gives you the option to choose which device do you want to record on. So this goes to the type of mic you want to use. In my own case, I'm using Rode NT USB. So I've got it selected over here. And then recording channels, I usually go for stereo. You can just select stereo over here. And then you can have the audio settings. There are other audio settings over here if you want. Next is the mic setting. You can check on the mic sensitivity from here. You can just increase or decrease just using this. Okay, so you can increase or decrease the sensitivity to, let's say, -8, and then you try to record again. Let's hear the difference. Hello and welcome to my channel. This is a test audio. Now this is very nice, and you can see the capture, the waveform is now very clear. Okay, so this is the recording sensitivity, the mic setting over here. And then you have the speaker settings over here. So which speaker are you using? This is where you set the volume. Okay, for example, I'm using the MacBook speaker, so it's going to, you can edit it over here. You can play around with the speaker, the volume control over here. You can increase or decrease accordingly as well, and then you can have a test of it. So down here, everything usually I used to leave it at default. For example, the project rate, I usually leave it at 4400. It does a good job. Snap to, I off this. If you want to enable it, you can enable how much time you've recorded, and then the starting and ending of the selection you can see from here, and how many minutes you've recorded you can see from here as well. As well as this is the playback speed. Okay, so you can increase it. Right now is x1, which is the default one. You can increase it to x2 if you want to double the speed, or you can reduce it to 0.5 if you want to make it in slow motion or thereabout. Another thing I didn't talk about is the audio settings over here. Okay, so you have a range of other effects from here. For example, you can increase or decrease the gain from the positive and negative directions, signifying increase and decrease accordingly. You can see the track number or the track you are working on or you are recording on. You can easily see that. And you can mute a particular track from here, or you can solo a particular track, which means you will mute every other track that is on the timeline, and then only that particular track will be allowed to be played. Now Audacity has brought in a new feature also called the share audio. You can share your audio on different timelines. You can link your account to another account. For example, you can get the link and share with people and share with people so that they can access your download, or they can access your audio editing or they're about. And you have the various zoom in and out features. You can zoom to fit, and you can zoom fit to project with. You can do other zoom in and zoom out accordingly using these features as well. And then here you have the timing of your recording. Okay, so as you record, you move from the beginning to the end, you can be seeing the timing at the top over here. So let's do some basic recording. Let's try to create a project by just selecting everything here, command A and press on delete. So let's try to create a simple project by just coming to file over here and click on save project, for example. Save project, and we can call it trial. You specify the location where you want to save it. You can just specify the location. For example, I want to save it in YouTube, and I create a new folder called Audacity. Say okay, and I save it over here. Now I want to do some basic recording. So to do that, all I need to do is to just start by pressing on the record button. Once I make sure my audio setup, my device is set correctly, and the output setup also is set correctly, and the sensitivity of the mic is set correctly, I can just press on record over here. The first thing you need to know is that as you want to start recording, it's good to allow the recording to pick the background noise before you start speaking. So during the editing, it becomes very easy for you to edit. So let's do some basic recording and see how far it has gone and see what we can pick out of it. So press the record button and then wait for it to pick the background, then I start speaking. And then when you get to the end as well, you can leave some profile so that it can capture the background also at that point. So let's press on record. Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Rashid, and this is just a mini testing of our Audacity, and to try to create some sound that can be much more professional than the one we used to create. So stay tuned and let's experience it together. All right, so now it has finished. I press the stop button and we can go back and play it to hear what it's going to sound. Like I said, initially we left it to pick the background, the background. We can click around and play this so that you can hear the noise that it has captured. This is very useful and handy when we are trying to edit, so you can just get the profile of the noise section and then you remove it directly from the entire recording. So this is the noise it has captured. Let's now start the editing, but let's hear the complete sound. Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Rashid, and this is just a mini testing of our Audacity, and to try to create some sound that can be much more professional than the one we used to create. So stay tuned and let's experience it together. All right, I think that's kind of sound good, but let's now try to see how we can make it better. Okay, so we can come back to the starting point and then we can try to get the profile of the noise area, for example the whole of this, and then we can come to the audio setup over here. You can come to audio setup, or you can still go to effects and you can come to noise removal and repair. You can just come to noise reduction over here, and then you can click to get the noise profile. So this is the area we've left for the noise profile. So once you click, it's going to capture this as a sample noise profile. Okay, so once you capture the noise profile, you come and click here to select, or you do Control A to select the entire clip. You select the entire clip and then you go back to the same effects and come to noise removal and repair, and then you can come to noise reduction as well. I usually keep everything at default and then come down to click on OK. The noise reduction, you can leave it at 12, sensitivity at 6, and the frequency smoothing at 3. Okay, I don't touch anything over here. So once you click on OK, it's going to carry out the removal process. And right now it has removed. Another thing I used to do is to go to do some compression. Okay, so I do some compression while still making sure that the entire clip is being selected. I can come back to effects and come to volume and compression, and then I come to compressor over here. I used to leave everything at default, the threshold at negative 12, the noise flow at negative 40, ratio as 2:1 and all that. So I leave everything at default and then I can click on apply. Okay, and you can see it compresses it a little bit. Or you can try to play and see how it sounds. Hello and welcome to my channel. Another thing I used to do is to still select everything and then come back to the effects and go back to filter and EQ. For example, I do some equalizations over here. So I come to EQ and filters, and then I come to filter curve EQ. I just click on it and I make sure I come to the presets over here and come to the factory presets and then select bass boost. Okay, this bass boost, I select it and then I make sure everything is on 9 decibel, and then click on apply. It's going to boost, give you some boost. The highs and the lows are going to be boosted, and then I do another second EQ and filters again, but this time around I still select filter curve EQ, but then in the presets I come to factory reset and then check on treble boost this time around, and I still make sure that everything is on 9 dB. Okay, so I hit on apply, and this gives us the other boost to the entire thing. Okay, so at this point I do normalization. So to normalize this, you can just come still all the way to effects while still selecting the entire clip. You can come to volume and compression. You can see normalize over here. Come to normalize. I used to normalize at -2, so I hit on apply, and it's going to give me this profile. So the next thing is I put in some limiters. So I come to effects also while still selecting the entire clip. I come to volume and compression. I come to limiter. I put some limiter to cut down the two highs and the two lows. Okay, two highs to cut it down. Okay, so you can see the limiter, and then I normalize again the last time. Okay, so I come down to volume and compression. I go to normalize and then normalize at -2 as well. And once I hit on -2, it's going to boost it a little bit. Okay, so after these little editings, let's try to play it and see how it sounds. I think it sounds much more professional now, so let's try to listen to it. Hello and welcome to my channel. I think you can tell that the difference is clear. It's just the steps, just follow the steps, and you can get your audio to be sounding so professional and fantastic, just like so. Hello and welcome to my channel. Very nice. Hello and welcome to my channel. This is Dr. Rashid, and this is just a mini testing of our Audacity and to try to create some sound that can be much more professional than the one we used to create. I think this sounds good and fantastic. So the last thing I used to do is to export my audio in MP3. So to do that, all you need to do is to make sure you come to file over here and come to export. You just make sure you save export as MP3. You just select it. Keep everything at default. Specify location. Right now, it's going to save it on our Audacity tutorial with .mp3 format. Keep everything here at default and just go ahead and click on save. Keep everything at default again, and then you just click on OK, and it's going to export this perfectly in MP3. So everything has been exported. So to check it, you can go back and check your file. Example, come to YouTube and then come to Audacity tutorial, and you can see it over here, trial.mp3. You can just click to have a preview. Hello and welcome. Yeah, so that's it. And basically this is how to use Audacity to capture your audio and to edit it to sound much more professional. If you enjoyed this video, ladies and gentlemen, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.